Honeybees and other insects pollinate 3/4 of America's crops. For all those fruits and veggies, thank a bee. But times are tough for these hard workers. Populations are declining and the cause is unclear. Fortunately, Penn Staters are on the case. I'm Bill Zimmerman. This is Penn State. Today, I'm speaking with Christina Grosinger. She's gonna be our tour guide to the wonderful world of bees. Christina, I've been stung before. Why should we have any love for these vicious creatures?
So first of all, they're not that vicious. So you'll see if we go into the hives later on. But honeybees and other insects are important for pollinating about 90% of the plants in the world. And so every time you eat a blueberry or bite into an apple or have a salad with tomatoes and cucumbers, or you eat your almonds, or you have coffee in the morning, you can thank bees for that. Our work and the work of many other labs around the world has shown is that there's no single factor that's really killing the bees right now. It's really more like death by a thousand cuts. And so bees are dealing with parasites, especially varroa mites, viruses, pesticides, and poor nutrition. And it's all of these factors together that are weakening the bees. And so American beekeepers are losing about 40% of their colonies every year, despite the fact that they're really trying very hard to manage them and provide them with everything they need to survive.
Here at Penn State, we have the Center for Pollinator Research, one of the nation's leading honeybee research facilities. Grosinger and a team of faculty and students from a wide array of disciplines are hard at work, all with one goal in mind, to support agriculture, from family farms to agribusiness, in the production of $30 billion worth of crops each year. To do this, researchers are focused on helping the honeybee grow and thrive in the face of a many-pronged crisis. Okay, we're gonna try some honey fresh from the honeycomb. Wow, look at that. I got a sweet tooth. This is just incredible. Good. So Christina, I think I have a new appreciation for our bee friends. How can I help them?
So one thing is to plant flowering plant species that are nutritious and attractive for bees in your gardens and at your businesses. We also encourage people to minimize the use of pesticides so that you use them as you need them to control the pests, but to do minimal damage to the bees. We have a lot of resources for helping people get started with bees. So we have an online course called Beekeeping 101, and also there's a lot of local beekeeper clubs that are always really excited to encourage new bees to join their group.
One more thing I want to know. How often do you describe your job as the bee's knees?
Bill, don't make me sick my bees on you.
I'm Bill Zimmerman. This is Penn State.